खुबोर कबातीसी टीवी लवन राशिफी दक ऑरेंज निसान लूम्सो पोनिया फैब्रिकेट चिलोंग रिंकट बट का फिटोरियम का दुकान की तियार किलान में कबा भातम हकदोर कबाबित हन्नोंग थमाई ओल्ड बीट हाउस चिलोंग
मिस्टर स्पीकर सर रिप्लाई टू स्टार्ट क्वेश्चन 89 ए यस सर द एमईपीडीसीएल वन टाइम सेटलमेंट ओटीएस स्कीम 2020 वाज लॉन्च्ड बाय Office Order Number MECL/CA/GA/7/2019/162, dated the 4th November 2020, for recovery of pending dues from the consumers. B. Sir, the total number of consumers who availed the one-time settlement, the OTS scheme, 2020, is 3,152. C. Sir, 1. Rebhoy, rupees 7,25,45,196. 2. East Khasi Hills, rupees 64,47,402. 3. West Khasi Hills, rupees 42,15,570. 4. Southwest Khasi Hills, rupees 35,05,355. 5. East Jaintia Hills, rupees 64,35,576. 6. West Jaintia Hills, rupees 9,47,27,905. 7. East Garo Hills, rupees 13,40,162. 8. West Garo Hills, rupees 1,12,400. 9. North Garo Hills, rupees 1,89,583. 10. South West Garo Hills, rupees 7,28,303. South Garo Hills, nil, sir. Total amount coming to rupees 19,02,47,452. D. Sir, as per MEPTCL one-time settlement, the OTS scheme 2020, by office order number MECL/CA/GA/7/2019/162, dated 4th November 2020, if the consumer failed to pay the amount settled as per the scheme, the power supply to the consumers shall be disconnected without any further notice.
Honorable Speaker, sir, from this reply to 89B, we could see that 3,152 consumers availed the OTS scheme. May I know from the Honorable Minister, sir, what was the original targeted number of consumers that the OTS intended to benefit, sir?
Sir, I don't have the figure of the total number of consumers which were targeted, but I do have the figure for the benefit of the Honorable Member of the total outstanding dues that were there, sir. As on December 2020, sir, it was 554.74 crores, sir. However, the number of consumers which was targeted, sir, that I can place on the table of the House, sir.
Sir, from the current figures of the liability and also from the meager number of 3,152 consumers that availed the OTS, so we could see that many consumers could not avail the OTS. However, with this poor response and lack of consumers coming forward to avail the OTS, the MECL took the decision to go ahead with the disconnection, even with this poor response from the people, sir. May I know the reason why they were in such a hurry, sir, seeing the poor response, sir?
Sir, we have to understand again, sir, that MECL is, and I've been saying this repetitively, sir, ad nauseum. But the fact is that, sir, MECL is facing acute financial stress, sir. And there is an urgency to recover whatever pending dues are there, sir. So therefore, sir, there are certain disconnections which are taking place, and some of them, due to these disconnections, have come forward and have availed this OTS, sir. And we have been able to make recovery of 19 crores 2 lakhs 47,452 because of the actions taken by the vigilance wing of the MECL, sir. So, sir, we have to understand that it is a very trying and difficult time for the MECL, sir.
Sir, in pursuance to this reply, sir, that the minister has just given, now, what is happening on the ground, sir? OTS has closed, disconnections have started. And some of the consumers, as the Honourable Minister has rightly pointed, they have come forward, gone to the retail, to the counters. One particular consumer I met on Saturday, sir, he had a due of 23,000 and he took 10,000 with him, sir, to pay. But then he was rejected. He was rejected. Now what is happening in this entire scenario, sir? Nobody is gaining. Nobody is gaining. The consumer, his power supply is disconnected. Here, the MECL is also not taking the payments, whatever is being paid by the consumer also. Because the OTS, as they say, has been the last date, even though extended, and even 50% payment also given. The MECL is not accepted, is not accepting the payments. So we're having a deadlock, sir, in the ground. On the ground, sir, there's a deadlock. So perhaps, sir, this entire thing needs to be reviewed, because out of the 554 crores, only 19 crores has been recovered. So perhaps there should be some laxity, some kind of arrangement to solve this ground problem, sir. Otherwise, then neither the consumer, even though they are paying a bit of what they can, that also is not accepted. Neither the MECL is also gaining any revenue. So I would request the Honourable Minister, sir, to kindly again review this decision at his level, so that the power supply can be reconnected, some dues also can be recovered out of the outstanding of 554 crores. This is my appeal and request, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sir, I'm very thankful to the Honourable Member, sir, for bringing this to light. And I'll be grateful, sir, if he can give me the particulars about the person who had a due of 23,000, he wanted to pay 10,000, and this was not accepted, sir. Because the OTS is flexible in nature, sir, and we understand the ground realities, and we are sensitive to the difficulties that people face, sir. And therefore, sir, if the need arises, sometimes, sir, these payments can be made in installments, maybe PDCs or in whatever nature, sir. So if there is a case, which is a particular case, which the Honourable Member from Umroy is mentioning about, so we can have a look into this as to why this had to happen, sir. Secondly, sir, the OTS has not closed, sir. It has been extended till March 2021, sir. And we know that, sir, that maybe, sir, the information has not been able to reach consumers, sir. This is a scheme, sir, to incentivize consumers to clear their outstanding dues, sir. And it is very clearly mentioned in the notice also, sir, that the OTS is happening now and it will not happen for the next 5 years. And also, sir, that after the validity of the OTS ceases, then what happens is that we will be going for disconnections. So I take this opportunity through you, sir, to also urge the people of the state to come forward and avail of this scheme, sir, because this is something which will not take place for the next 5 years, and also we will be going on a disconnection spree, sir.
Sir, the particular consumer was Mr. T. Makri from Klo Village, and he's only one of them, sir. And from Klo Village, nearly 30-40% of the household consumers have had their power disconnected. And similar situations are in other villages, sir. I have taken the case of this particular person because he has mentioned the amount, I've seen his bill, and also the incident that has occurred. So I still, sir, appeal for again a review, sir. The OTS is one part of it. Maybe by end of 31st March, you may not be able to recover even another 10% or so. So what will happen to the other liabilities if the disconnections continue at this rate? Will the consumers get their connections back after 5 years, sir? That is a concern, sir. Thank you, sir.
I've noted down the name of the concerned person. And what was the name of the village?
Clough village, Clough.
Clough. Sir, the fact, whatever concerns has been raised by the honourable member, sir, these are genuine concerns, and I can understand the kind of concerns that he has, sir, for his people and also for the general public at large, sir. And we are in the process, sir, of trying to strengthen the system whereby we will have more reach out or outreach for our consumers so that they know of this, and we can try to bring them closer and convince them to avail of this OTS, sir. So we will be, sir, sitting down and reviewing this, sir, and his suggestion is taken into consideration, sir.
Yes, Vatsalyan.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir. After last session, now it seems the MECL department has started installing the meter box. Now OTS is for the pending dues from the one which is using the current. But still, there are bills which is still going to the, you know, villages without the current. Now after the last session, they have started installing the meter box, but they have failed to give the current yet. But still they are giving the current. So I would like to request the Honorable Minister to look into this matter seriously. It seems like it's a job, but for those people living in the villages, it's a very gruesome, you know, seems like an attack, because it deals with the money and then, you know, their livelihood also. So let me tell you the name of the area also. It's a Saka Boldamri area where they have already installed the meter box, and the Badupara Ganangatham, where I have mentioned the village last time. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir.
The point noted, sir.
Madalwun.
So looking at the response in C, the amount, total amount recovered, may I know from the Honorable Minister, if we see at the 5 district of Khasi Jhantia Hills, the recovered is around more than 18 crore. In Garo Hills, it is only 23 lakh. May we get the impression that the billing efficiency in Garo Hills, especially South Garo Hills, it is very good, that they have paid on time, there is no outstanding, that only from Khasi region more payment has come. May we know the reason of this disparity of collections?
So this is the total amount recovered through the one-time settlement scheme, sir. So the fact is that maybe the people in Riboy, East West Khasi Hills, East Jhantia Hills have been more forthcoming in their forthcoming to avail the scheme, sir. Maybe the response from Garo Hills is a little slow, sir. Nonetheless, sir, we will be ramping up our outreach, as I said, sir, and we will try to reach out to as many consumers in Garo Hills also, so that they can come forward and avail this OTS, sir.
Sir, one more information. May we know from the Honorable Minister if we have the answer, or if not, it can be placed on the table of the House. The breakup for Riboy district and West Jhantia Hills district, how much has been paid by the factories and how much has been paid by the household consumer? The breakup of these two in these two districts.
Sir, the breakup, I presume Honorable Member wants to know the names of the consumers?
Not the name, just how much it has been paid by the factories and how much has been paid by the household.
Sir, I can provide that information, sir. Sir, I'll place it on the table of the House.
Thank you.
Buckingham Farms.
Sir, after the one-time settlement, how many has a household in Garo Hills has been disconnected and in Khasi Hills, Brivoy district has been disconnected.
So that again is a very exhaustive list, sir. And if the Honourable Member so wishes, I can place that on the table of the House.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Bawai Lal, please.
Honourable Speaker, sir, looking at the reply of 89C, we can see that West Chanty Hills availed the highest of this OTS scheme. So, sir, and if we plus the of the West Chanty Hills and Brivoy, it's almost 85%, sir. But, sir, I would like to submit here that last time there was a load shedding in February, West Chanty Hills and Brivoy, the number of hours for load shedding was the highest, sir. So I would like to urge the department if there is any more load shedding, which I hope not, sir. So I'd like to request that to see this aspect of payment also, because it's discouraged the people who come forward and pay regularly, sir.
Sorry.